Hello everyone. When logging into PhpMyAdmin, you can access MySQL and receive the following error 2054, server requested authentication method unknown to the client, or error 1045, access denied for user using password. If you have the same problem, please continue to watching this video to find a solution. I make a three-part tutorial to log in PhpMyAdmin and MySQL database in the following 8 steps. We will make 4 sample users to show the solutions. In part 2, we will learn how to use MySQL crosses, alter, and update to resolve errors 2054 and 1045. In part 3, you can also create a new user to resolve this error. At the same time, you will learn how to set up default authentication. In this video, I will elaborate on the cause of the error and complete steps on how to find your MySQL server location and force a safe stop of the server. All of this will be run through the command line Unix bash. So let's get started. Before that, please subscribe to HelpBuddy Solutions. If the video is helpful, please give me a like. You can leave your questions or friendly comments. To understand the error, you must know the version of PHP and MySQL Server you have installed. In the dock section on the desktop, click System Preference and then select MySQL. The panel displays my server current version. When enter your PHP info page, you can see PHP current version at the top section. Scroll down to MySQL ND, which is my SQL native driver section. Add loaders plugins here, which is the current plugin contains my SQL native password, but it does not come with caching SHA-2 password plugin. I once got the plugin in the attachment of the old version, but the current version does not support the plugin. The PHP versions before 7.2 sets my SQL 8 default password plugin to my SQL native password. But MySQL 8 itself set to a caching SHA-2 password as default authentication. The error is that the requested authentication method of the MySQL server cannot be authenticating from the client logging into PhpMyAdmin. The difference between these two plugins is the encryption length. If both use different password plugin setting, the user password cannot be verified and error 2054 is caused. Otherwise, if both use the same plugin settings, but the password cannot be verified, it will result in error 1045. Error 1045 or 2054 is a different code, but the same problem exists. The user cannot verify login from PhpMyAdmin page, so the solution to these two errors is the same. You need to use bash terminal CLI to reset the plugin and authentication string. Open the terminal. Enter the following line: ps space aux means run all the user's processes that have not been executed, and space key pipe space grab like a space mysql. Use global regular expressions to send the output to the command shell for searching MySQL, and press enter. You can see the line on MySQL path, which is the installation location. Copy the path and paste it to a new line, leaving a space. Enter 2 dashes and version, then press enter. You can see the MySQL version currently installed for my Mac OS. Let's copy the first 3 directories of the path and open the finder. Click on the top menu type Go and then select Go to folder. Paste it into the field and click the Go button. You can see the shortcut MySQL directory contains everything. And the next one is the backup directory where the MySQL installation location. When entering MySQL shortcut directory and click the bin folder, MySQL is a command line client for interactively executing SQL statements. we can see MySQLD, that is MySQL database system. Back to the support files, that is MySQL server installation location in the directory. With these three paths and follow the steps below to use the bash terminal to access MySQL without using PhpMyAdmin user password. Back to terminal, type sudo space, copy and paste the path, take off the D to execute MySQL command line, make a space and dash U, make a space, root as login username, and hit enter. Insert your Mac user password and press enter again. You will see the error 1045, access denied. Before running the MySQL command line, we must first stop the MySQL server. Type sudo space, paste the path again, change the path from bin /MySQL to support-files/MySQL.server. Leave a space and type stop plus enter. The error of server not running. Use MySQL control panel and plus the stop MySQL server button to make a force stop the server and enter your Mac user password. Click OK. You can see it turns to red light after the server stop. Back to terminal, run the command line again. If and of course PID file error, because the server has already stopped. It won't be stopped again, so that's why the error. So we have to change to start to test the connection. Plus enter. Then try to stop again. Now it can be connected and stopped through by the bash command. If you want to learn more about computing, programming, and web development, please like my videos and subscribe to PhpMyAdmin Solutions channel.